places and spaces to be with lots of people who are in the creative arts world, because I'm actually an artist. I'm a politician now, but I trained as a painter. I have been a painter and an artist longer than I've been a politician. I know the difficulties of living off what you make. I had a gallery in Liverpool with a friend of mine. I know how difficult it is for those who are trying to get the art to a wider public. I also trained as an arts teacher, actually, because typically my parents thought I should do something useful rather than being an artist. And I thought a lot about arts education and what the arts is. And the fact that actually all these different qualities in us come together. I mean, you're not just one or the other. We are a lot of things, and our skills and talents come together, particularly at a later stage in your life, like in mine, where things come together again, and that in itself is a joy. But I believe we're all born creative. And you only have to look at young children when they grow up, and whoever has children, you know, it starts very early. You put a pen in a child's hand, and they draw. And they paint, and they use colour, and they sing, and they dance. And yet it seems that our system, our society, our educational system seems to beat creativity out of our young people at an early age. By the time they're 12, they say, I can't draw. Yes, you can draw. You could draw when you were four. And what is it that actually creates these barriers in us, in our young people? And that is, for me, a very big discussion that might be discussed here today, particularly how we are breaking down barriers. And the recent years have been particularly difficult because everybody who is in the arts world and who wants to bring creativity into our lives, because essentially we are creative beings and our feelings are so much actually connected into our creativity. And all of you who are working in that field seem that in the last 10 years at least, but even before, we seem to be on the retreat and have to fight against invisible and very visible barriers of how we are making that happen in our society. So I've been asked earlier, what do you hope from this afternoon to happen? And first of all, when you put a lot of creative people in a space together, something very unexpected can happen. So first of all, I rely on you for something amazing and unexpected to happen this afternoon, for big discussions that obviously can't just be contained in one afternoon, but for discussions to start. But let me hear how we best make the most of very limited resources. And that has to be one of our big focuses this afternoon. But I do believe partnership workings are also a key. It's not always about the amount of money, it's about how effectively you put everything together. For a long time, I organized an arts festival in Rochdale. I was already a politician by then. But we organized an arts, it was called Arts Feel Good Festival in Rochdale. And so I've worked over a year with arts groups in 2010. And the difficulties about accessing funding, but at the same time, creating a platform for all the different forms of arts to be showcased in the time I was a councillor was already, I remember, a challenge because resources were becoming much more finite and people couldn't just rely on grants and money that they have been receiving all along for many years. So it is not a new challenge, and I'm sure over the last 10 years you've already learned a lot, but it's becoming more and more difficult. And I'm so grateful that you're here to assist all of us to understand better how we can make the most of very limited resources. But as I say, I'm expecting the unexpected. Let's be creative about how we go about it, and I wish us all a very productive afternoon.